tonight is a celebration. A celebration of innovation and a celebration of CIC coming to Rotterdam.
And indeed, we are here together to celebrate and to build further on the development surrounding CIC Rotterdam.
So there's a wonderful future ahead, but we really need to have startups. No longer the focus is on integrating new activities, but on cooperating with them.
What drives the act of choosing to work with someone else?
The few companies that actually manage to change and to let others develop their services on top of their infrastructures or on top of their software, those are the companies that seem to be doing well.
Today we're talking about the patterns that drive innovation in a city, in a country, what the underlying themes are, why it works, why it doesn't work, and how to promote it and make it stronger. I'm very excited to be part of that dialogue. We think of innovation as being a product of three ingredients: money, ideas, and talent.
There's a very interesting marriage to be had, as described today, between big companies, existing companies, and startups, both in terms of technology and in terms of culture.
So we try to create a culture that is actually allowing innovation, allows people to attract talent. It's certainly not a secret. It's the way how you do that.
We always have to think about new ideas in the future and trying to create an innovative atmosphere in our company. The problem is how to do that in a conservative world as the construction industry is.
It's always difficult for ventures to engage with corporates and for corporates to find the right ventures. And that's very important. How do you do that?
There is a myth about, you know, those big companies, those very fast-growing startups, they're led by one person, mostly male. What we found out when we did this research, that's not true.
In many cases, successful startups have all the management as a track record of an entrepreneur, and especially also has a team.
And that's why I'm here, because I'm trying to learn how to do this. I'm trying to figure out what structure is working in a large organization, how can we combine that with our existing business on our existing client base. That's a very fascinating challenge.
Perhaps the biggest challenge we face as a company in terms of going into new stuff is not just the technology into innovation and how we work with others to that extent, but is business model innovation.
And I think the real opportunity at the end of the day, if you think of this in economic terms, one of the reasons I think companies are so interested in ecosystems is because of the concept of network effects. But there's a second order exponential impact, which is it's not just the number of participants, it's the speed of learning.
How likely is it that you will then suddenly turn around and say, hey, I'm going to share, I'm going to be open, I'm going to open my IP to the world and allow all these startups to come in and innovate with me?